Hey everybody, today's lesson is all about cardinal numbers, how we use them with examples and pronunciation. A cardinal number is a number like 1, 2, 3 that tells the quantity of something or someone. When we use cardinal numbers in other ways, we refer to those with the term nominal number. That's just the start. We use cardinal numbers to communicate a value of a noun like how many. Nominal numbers are used to give a name or identify something with one or more numbers. For this exercise, I'm going to be discussing both cardinal numbers and nominal numbers. So, what is a cardinal number? Examples could be one chair, two tables, three spoons, four people. Nominal numbers are used for everything we want to identify, but not used to count. Your phone number is a nominal number. Your address contains a nominal number. Zip codes or postcodes, model identification, sports team member, all use nominal numbers. Remember, cardinal numbers are used to count. Nominal numbers are used to identify. I have examples to share with you, but first, I'm going to help you with pronunciation. Here are the numbers up to the number 30. Listen carefully. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, and 30. Now I need to tell you that sometimes in American English, those numbers from 20 on up sound a little differently than you heard me pronounce with the T sound. Listen again, I'm going to do it just a little bit faster with just the numbers from 20 to 30. Listen carefully. 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. You'll notice you didn't hear so much of the T. That's more natural for American English speakers. Here are some more numbers. 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100, 200, 300, 400, etc. 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, etc. 1,000,000, 2,000,000, etc. One of something is simple. Examples like one chair, one table, one apple. Two or more require a plural noun. Most plural nouns just require an S at the end of the word for more than one of something. Two chairs, three tables, four cups, five apples, six oranges, seven bananas, eight cars, 9 days, 10 weeks, 11 months. That's pretty easy, right? I just added an S to all of these words. Some irregular plural nouns are two children, three men, four people, five teeth, six mice, seven women, etc. These are all irregular plural nouns, and you'll notice that they're all spelled differently than the noun we used for just one. When you're writing English, use the number word, not the number from 1 to 9. Examples for written English are 1 day, 2 jobs, 3 beds, 4 cars, 5 keys, 6 pens, etc. Now you'll notice I spelled out the word for all of these examples from 1 to 6, but go all the way to 1 to 9 in written English. Spell out the word. Don't use the singular, numeral, or cardinal number. From the number 10 and up, it's appropriate to use cardinal numbers instead of writing the words. Some examples are 10 teachers, 20 friends, 100 students, 1,000 ants, 1 million people. Can you imagine? Here are some spoken English pronunciation examples. Remember, I speak American English. 101, 302, 1,223, 2022, 2021, 2020, 2000. Those are all for years, right? The year 2022, the year 2021, etc. 1999, 1990, 1953, 1900. These are just a few examples of how we would pronounce years. Here are some addresses. 123 Elm Street. I could say 123 Elm Street. People do that, but it might be more common with three numbers to say 123 Elm Street. 1533 Vine Street. When we use the teens, 13, 14, 15, we often use that number first and then add the rest. 10472 Fifth Avenue. For long numbers like that, then you would actually pronounce each number individually. Here is a phone number example. 555-327-0568. Although zero is a number, it's often pronounced as an O, as in the alphabet, when we refer to numbers. So to recap, remember that cardinal numbers tell how many, nominal numbers name things. Hey, that's it for today's lesson. Please do your homework, stay safe, and see you next time. Class dismissed. Thanks for watching. If you haven't already, please subscribe to our channel.